Let's continue. With the subject, language of creation, silence. When you smile, the language of it is silence. There is a tremendous chemistry happening within your system of the body when you smile. Isn't it when you're happy? You smile. You laugh. You relax, calm, and still. However, it is you and only you who is creating that experience within you. That's why it is very important to awaken the awareness and consciousness within you, because we don't cause the meaning of awareness, the meaning of consciousness, for this consciousness, this awareness is us. Needs only to be awakened. When you are in that dimension, accessing the other dimensions of existing lives in this vast cosmos universe where we are living is very, very possible. But if it is not awakened in you, you are just limited to your senses. But if you are, you can go beyond the boundaries of your senses. Will lead you to knowing more, the unlimited miracles and mystery of life. My life, your life. There's no such as like that. There's only life. And you're not the one, nor any one of us, who caused this life, who created this life. There is the source of all lives existing, and it will lead you to that, which actually that is existing in each one of us and all existing lives in this cosmos. And the language of this is silence. Within us, you don't see the inward what's happening in the system, but it is always working for life. As you sit there and I sit here, inside the system of this body, it's just working for life. Working for health. If you are aware of that, you can be well every day. What makes us sick? It is our own doing. Human beings that make us sick. You can only know life if you are aware of it, if you are conscious of it. Not only what you call my life or your life. There is no such as life there. There is only life. And this life that you and me have, we share a piece of it. Don't try to be silent, because you is silence, because you are one of the many pieces of life. It's done in silence. Did you ever watch the growing plant? It's just done silent. Did you ever notice the growth happening of a human body from when it was born until growing to infancy, babyhood, childhood, adulthood? It is just happening in silence. Did you ever watch and pay attention to animals when they test their survival? They're doing it in silence. And the rising of the sun up to its setting is just happening in silence. The appearance of the moon, its movement, and its brightness radiating is just happening in silence. Friends, the language of creation is silence. Creation is silence. You have that for you are. What disturbs you? It is your own making. The tools that you have as a human being is your mind. There are many thoughts playing here, depending on the data that you have gathered and accumulated. It's playing, recycling, and it's limited. When this runs in your thoughts, in your mind, do not focus your energy to it. If you do, that's the direction of the energy. It just run and run, pops up. But just let it go. That's the nature of the mind. Because you accumulated and put it there, it will always pop up. It will always run. Especially if you put your energy towards it. You keep on thinking, imagining, flashing back the memories, imagining what has not happened yet, and worrying. That's the nature of the mind. Because you accumulated and put it there, it will always run. Do not put your energy towards that direction. Let it go. You can sit here and just look and watch the thoughts and just let it go. The second tool that you have as a life is your emotion. Emotions, these are your feelings. These are your tools. If you don't put energy towards it, it's just emotion, feelings. There is a connection when you put energy to your thoughts connected to the emotion. That's why the thoughts that is running, don't put your energy towards that. If you do, that's your emotion is connected to that and your feelings. The third tools that you have as a life is your body, the physicality of your body. These are your tools. You have to be aware of the body that you have. Listen to the body. And I would like to remind each one of you watching this, we are part of the soil. You have to get it now. Don't get this when you're almost dying. Unto dust we came, and unto dust we shall return. The soil that we have now is suffering so much, is in danger, is degenerating. If this is happening, the body that we have is connected to that, because this is part of the soil, the crop of the soil. This is our tool. We have to do the proper way of treating this body. The way we treat the soil is somehow the way we are treating our body nowadays.